Welcome and good evening to you all. I am Dr. Samuel Sims, principal of New Paltz High School, and this evening I welcome you to our 91st annual graduation celebration. This evening we are proud to present 160 candidates for graduation. I would ask everyone to please stand as the candidates enter for graduation and to remain standing while you're led to do the Pledge of Allegiance and the playing of the Star Spangled Banner.
Thank you. republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
USA!
Among our graduating class as one of the brightest and most hardworking of her peers. I've had the privilege of not only seeing her brilliance in the classroom in the past 4 years, but also her dedication to her classmates, working alongside her in her role as class treasurer for the past 2. Please join me in welcoming the class of 2023 salutatorian, Lauren Stokely.
This school. I stayed after school many times for calculus, and Ms. Stewart was always there to help me, and she did so much to help me relearn the material. I'm done.
I'm evening. I'm Kathleen Schneck-Suma, Assistant Principal, and it is my honor to present to you the awards for this evening. The Harriet Cunningham Memorial Award, Kylie Ayala. Manny Art Award, Nicola Salastrini.
Scholarship, Jenna Shapiro.
Evan Meyer Memorial Scholarship, Beckenwyers. R.W. McNeilis Memorial Scholarship, Sage Rachetti and Billy Sturgis. New Paltz Music Department Scholarships. Julia Crofton, Brian Hyland, Julia Zemsky, Josephine Quinn, Lindsay Clinton, Andrew Wildman.
Scholarship, Jenny Trevira.
Memorial Scholarship, Liam Delmar. The Richard W. Wires Memorial Scholarship, Maxwell Hawkins and Sophia Lucci. The Peer Leadership Education Award, Sophia Gallo.
Congratulations to to all of us graduating. We spend about 14% of our entire lives in school, and I know that every single one of us has earned some kind of knowledge from that experience. Lots of us learned math, and lots of us didn't learn math. But in my opinion, that's not what matters. What matters is that even just by existing and attending this school, we've all lived. We learned about making friends and we learned about losing them. We learned about grappling with new concepts and finally understanding them. Also, what I know I learned by both by being physically in this school and by attending it remotely, obligatory for reference, is that in order to make the most of anything in life, you have to turn being conscious into being awake. I'm sure we've all had a period of time where finding the energy to do more than the bare minimum felt impossible. But I'm also sure that we've all found ways to escape that, even momentarily, and I'd like to offer my solution to that issue. I learned by being here that instead of floating through life, we should observe instead of just see, feel instead of just touch, and listen instead of just hear, even though it's often more difficult. I also learned that in order to feel fulfilled by any experience I have, I need to intentionally take that experience and use it to its maximum. I can read hundreds of books on hundreds of different topics and still not be as wise as someone who spent that time exploring their world. Because in the grand scheme of things, having that life experience for yourself, just like our teachers do, is far more valuable than reading about someone else's life experience. For that reason, I ask everyone here today to consider their approach to each day. When you wake up, it's okay to focus on just making it through another day. But once in a while, try to do more. Try to appreciate yourself. Try to connect with others, and try to go explore. I read a lot of philosophy books, but the novel that has impacted me the most so far has to be Slaughterhouse-Five by Kurt Vonnegut. And so I'll leave you all with one of my favorite quotes from that book. I asked myself about the present, how wide it was, how deep it was, how much was mine to keep. Personally, I'd like to believe that all of it is ours to keep.
saw Global 9 and 10, U.S. history, participation in government, economics, and I'm sure I'm missing a few. So I'm sure that most of you guys have had them at some point in your high school experience. And I was thinking about it, and the only thing that I don't like about him is that he's a Red Sox fan. It's my pleasure and great honor to introduce our keynote speaker, Mr. Gibb.
Yeah!
Exactly what's going to happen, what NPZ's getting.
kid you're going to run into in the hallway, what art will be showcased in displays, but what I could always count on was the character you possess, the care you have for one another. It's not to say that every day you fall is perfect or that we have a secret ingredient for some utopian society, but it has a character that not all places have. One that you students created, sustained, and hopefully have passed on to the younger classes. The class of 2023 is filled with people with creative talents, strong work ethic, and empathy for our shared humanity. These characteristics bode well for all of us as you enter the fray of post-high school life. Now, I try to avoid phrases such as the real world. Your experiences are real, and they should not be demeaned or diminished simply because you're on a different stage of your life journey. I also try to never say, these are the best days of your lives. Who needs that pressure? Especially for those of you going through difficult times. If you look to your right, if you look to your left, I'm sure you will find the face of a person who has benefited from the compassion you've shown. I know that because I've witnessed it. Your empathy for shared humanity, I would argue, is as important a skill as the creativity and hard work bring to any situation. One of the challenges we often place upon ourselves is the quest to be original, to make something or to have an idea that has never been expressed before. Since being asked to give this commencement speech, I've watched the likes of Denzel Washington, Tom Hanks, and Chadwick Boseman looking for inspiration. While the themes of these speeches are universal, the delivery is always different. You see this in music as well. I don't know this, but Ed Sheeran recently brought in his guitar to the courtroom as he defended himself in a copyright trial. He stated that most songs are built on four chords, air, C, G, D, and A, right? Okay, modern music necessarily builds on the music of the likes of Paul McCartney, Marvin Gaye, and one of my favorites from the 90s, David Grohl, Nirvana, and Foo Fighters. You see, we are all standing on the shoulders of giants, as Sir Isaac Newton once said, paying homage to like Copernicus and Galileo. Everything we see around us was once in between someone's ears. Our creations build upon those that occurred before us. New melodies, poems, and machines have been built upon previous efforts. Just look at the magical Harry Potter franchise. I've had many conversations, Liam, before class, after class, about what had to be its inspiration, Star Wars. Lightsabers turned into wands, Obi-Wan turned into Dumbledore, Luke, Harry, Leia, Hermione, Han Solo, and Ronald Weasley. Innovation and invention don't have to be completely original just to have value. Adam Smith wrote about the assembly line more than 100 years before industrialists put into regular use. Elizabeth Cady Stanton wrote that all men and women are created equal 72 years before the 19th Amendment was ratified. Billie Holiday sang Strange Fruit. Langston Hughes wrote I Too Sing America decades before the federal government would have the courage to act upon these sentiments. All worthy ideas that needed brave, courageous people to act. You must be present and use your voice to act. During your high school career, you've been exposed to many mathematical and scientific concepts, life lessons from your history, world languages, and English classes. In your physical education classes and sports teams, you've seen what's possible when you push your physical limits, devoting your efforts to the scene, the team, something bigger than yourself. My wish for you is not to take the easy way out, not to accept limits imposed upon you by those saying, that's impossible, that's too hard, you will never convince everybody. Avoid the easy way out presented with the likes of ChatGPT. Do not accept blindly the words of a talking head on cable news or that that authoritative sounding voice on a podcast. Use the reasoning skills you've been armed with when your teachers brought you to the library without research assignments, or perhaps a project you completed in painting or economics class. Our role here at New Paltz High School is not to teach you what to think, but teach you how to think. Read, and read some more. Use your talents, your work ethic, and your beautiful empathy to fight for our shared humanity. Read, think, act, reflect, and then start the whole process over again. I don't know, maybe read about how inflation is impacting food insecurity. All right, I can teach economics, I can dream. All right, I don't expect it, it's not an assignment attached to it, but, well, maybe instead, next time you're scrolling through Instagram and you see a reel about a family who is hungry, you decide to donate to the family of New Paltz. That alone will not end world hunger. One shovel of dirt never built a canal or moved a mountain. But you're not alone. Your actions may inspire others to grab their proverbial shovels, start digging, and before you know it, a pathway to that issue that you care about and so passionate about has been made. Now, I've gone this far without referencing what I often carry in my back pocket, the U.S. Constitution. Roman and EZ claim to have it downloaded on their phone, but I'm not buying it. I'm not buying it. It's okay, guys. You're still social studies school. It's all right. The Constitution, along with the most famous breakup letter in world history, the one that told Great Britain in the immortal words of Taylor Swift that we would never, ever, ever get back together. The Declaration of Independence. It's laid the foundation of American democracy and set the values that give our nation identity, ideas that hold us together. Among the goals of the nation, listed in the preamble, include that we the people are given the power, perhaps the responsibility, to create a more perfect union and to secure the blessings of liberty for ourselves and our posterity. Our nation has had many wonderful achievements, has led the world when the world needed a leader, has shown courage in the face of fear. I know that you have not waited until graduation to act on these goals. Many of you have already started. Among you are journalists for the Maroon, our school newspaper, poll watchers for our local elections, volunteers for New Paltz organizations such as the Youth Center and Nothing Library. Your actions may not be as harrowing as Malala's was in Pakistan, or as headline-grabbing as Greta Thunberg's in her fight to save the planet. But many of you have grabbed your proverbial shovel. You've already started to get things done. You are taking action, you are using your voice. And it's completely normal not to know yet where your passions are, or how exactly you would articulate a more perfect union. Most of our daily decisions are mundane in nature. Where to eat, what movie to watch, what to wear. And needless to say, not all of our choices have been right. We've made mistakes. Our nation has made mistakes too, and undoubtedly will do so again. How we respond in these moments will be a testament to our collective character. It has been and always will be. And we are living in a time where being critical of our nation's past is viewed by some as disrespectful, something to be avoided. But is it? I don't know, should we approach our own lives this way? To excuse, to ignore? Or is it better to look in the mirror, reflect upon our decisions, and with determination and courage, do better next time? Do we the people, the U class of 2023, have the resolve to do better, to be more perfect? As you know from your study of history, and many of you taking my classes, America has not always lived up to its founding ideas. Our nation at times has experienced a disconnect between its actions and its stated values. Similar, perhaps, to the choices you made while growing up that maybe didn't align with what your family values were. We've all been there. Many of these actions and events in American history occurred before we were born. But we feel and experienced a lasting impact. What then is our responsibility? I'd like you to consider this. America was an old house with a car that you purchased. You could not be held responsible for the damage done before you bought it. Well, once it's yours, don't you want to repair it, improve upon it, make it more perfect? The Pledge of Allegiance asks us to uphold liberty and justice for all. I ask you, class of 2023, to use your voice to fight for a world with liberty and justice for all. No matter what our gender, race, religion, age, preference, that would be a pledge worth taking. And in my humble opinion, I think you can take it too. I ask you to be present for each other and with one another. Be empathetic to each other's life, liberty, and pursuit of happiness. And then one final thought, and once again, thank you for the time and opportunity to speak to you. There's more than one pathway in life, more than one metric in which to measure success. Success is often viewed by attaining a certain GPA or by how much you've accumulated in your bank accounts, perhaps even likes on social media. But years and months from now, as you're walking down the street and you see one another for the first time since the times of New Paltz High School, will you cross the street? Cross to avoid the person you see heading your way, or cross to shake their hand, share a memory, give a hug. I hope you would cross the street to say hello to your old social studies teacher. Thank you and congratulations to New Paltz High School graduating class of 2023.
Before I present our class of 2023 graduates, I would like to share that this evening, Superintendent Stephen Prado has to attend his son's graduation ceremony. He does send his congratulations to each and every graduate and their family. Congratulations on reaching this momentous milestone in your lives. Today marks the end of one chapter and the beginning of another. As you move on to the next phase of your journey, I want to share with you a simple yet profound message. There is always tomorrow. My father is a Baptist preacher. And if you know anything about a Baptist church, there is a lot of participation of the audience. So I want you to turn to the neighbor to your right and say, there is always tomorrow. And now you're going to turn to the neighbor on your left or right. I'm just messing it up. The right and say, there is always tomorrow. Of a new day. It is about the endless possibility that tomorrow holds. It is about the fact that no matter what challenges you may face today, there is always the hope and the opportunity for a brighter tomorrow. As you leave this school and venture out into the world, you will undoubtedly you may stumble and fall, and it may seem like there is no way forward. But remember, there is always tomorrow. You have the power to learn from your mistakes, to grow stronger and wiser, and to keep moving forward towards your goals. At the same time, it is important to recognize that tomorrow is not a guarantee. Life is unpredictable, and we never know what the future holds. So while we should always strive to improve ourselves and pursue our dreams, we should always cherish the present moment and make the most of every opportunity that comes our way. As you go forth from this graduation ceremony, I urge you to hold on to the message that there is always tomorrow. Let it be a guiding principle in your life, a reminder that no matter what happens, there is always hope and a chance for a better future. Congratulations once again on your graduation, and I wish you all the best in your future endeavors. May you make the most of every tomorrow that comes your way.
Jay Castellanos.
Tardello. Evelyn Siono. Lindsay Amelia Clinton. Philip Joseph Calangio IV. Ella Margaret Constable. Phoebe Cosgrove. Julia Tori Crofton.
Thank you. Jumana Hansel. Maxwell Bowen Hawkins. Marco Amelia Keenan. Ethan Heller. Lily Zedra Horowitz. Laura Ann Hubby. Madison Alexis Humlock. Ryan Thomas Hyland. Eric De Jesus Jimenez. Taylor A. Payne. Beta Sky Keon. Kimberly Q. Hayden Vincent Camp. Owen Colasai. Caleb Lai. Joshua Adam Lavdani. Rows are standing. Maxwell C. Levine. Sophia Autumn Lawyer. Nora Foster Lukomsky Preston. Here's Gregory Lutz. Margaret Jean Lynn. Michael Patrick Lynn. Shane K. Marr. Jahara Maliha. Alexander Rafael Mancilla Alvarez. Emmanuel Ryan Markman. Carly Francis McKnight. Dakota Joseph McQuiston. Bilal Maherzad. Henry Edward Millman. Jefferson Jesus Monroy. Brendan Montero. Kyle T. Newman. Nora Ann Nielsen. Melissa Niemis. Shannon Grace O'Donnell. Michael M. O'Dell. Zoe Ogden. Kyle Matthew Oldham. Logan M. Morgan. Ariana Nicole Phillips. Lacey DeWitt Hindar. Davina Autumn King. Christian D. Platoni. Ethan A. Pollard.
Yeah. Dalton Bennett Beter. Cleo Elena Van Rosa. Fiona Ryan Walsh.
By the PTSA. Thank you all for joining us tonight, and again, congratulations.